In this video, we're going to look at eye strikes. Strikes to the eyes are extremely effective in self-defense situations. Obviously, they're incredibly dangerous. You could cause permanent damage to your attacker. So this is why eye strikes are outlawed in boxing and MMA matches and almost all sports. But in a real life situation, when you don't know what this guy's capable of, or if he's got a weapon, or if there's multiple assailants, or he's bigger than you or stronger than you, you use whatever you can use to get away. Eye strikes are great because if someone can't see, they really can't fight. And there's a number of different ways to do it. One of the easiest ways to use an eye strike is if someone keeps coming at you and you're in this defensive position saying, hey, back off, leave me alone, and you've tried backing off and they keep coming at you. One thing I like to do to get someone to back off is to kind of push off them a little bit. It's not an attack, but it just helps me get out of their space quickly. So if they're getting in my face, I don't know what their intentions are, I kind of push off them a little bit just to buy myself some space. And the least threatening way of doing this is just to kind of push off their chest and their arms. Helps me get away. But if this escalates and they keep coming at you, there's nothing that says you can't push off their eyeballs. It's the same movement. Instead of just going back on my own momentum or pushing off their chest a little bit, I'm pushing off their eyes. I'm not aiming for their eyes. I'm not trying to pick one out. I'm just splaying my fingers like this, and I'm aiming in the general direction of their eyes. There's a good chance something will catch. If it doesn't catch, I'm pressing off their face. It doesn't matter. But on the off chance one of these fingers catches their eye, it could end the fight right there. It really sucks when you get poked in the eye with anything. Even getting a little speck of dust or a little tiny splinter of wood in your eye will be extremely painful and debilitating. So imagine if you're there and this guy's feeling tough and you just jam him in the eye, like that'll give you enough time to get away. So again, I just practice this move of getting back, de-escalating, but then I add in aiming for his eyes. Roughly aiming for his eyes. And I do it with this front hand because it's closer. It would be awkward to do it with this hand and push off at the same time. Maybe if I were standing like this, I could do it with two hands. But I find that I'm trying to stay as far away from him as I can. This arm can really reach him with my fingers from quite a distance. He may not think that I can reach him. It's hard for me to punch him from this range, but I can hit his eyes from this range. So someone gets in your space, they won't leave you alone. You've told them time and time again, try going for their eyes and backing up at the same time. A second way to use an eye strike, which is much more aggressive, is the rake. So this would be up close. If someone grabs you, maybe they're gonna pick you up and throw you to the ground, maybe drop you on your head and knock you out, maybe try to assault you, maybe try to rape you, whatever it is. If they get in close, you can just think like a cat, just like a wild cat with claws. And if their arms are locked around you, then their arms and their hands are not protecting their face. So you always want to think about what's exposed on your attacker. So from here, I can just rake at them like a mad person and really do a lot of destruction. Believe me, they will let go of you if you do that. It's extremely painful to have someone tearing at your eyes. And it's discombobulating, like you don't expect it and everything kind of shuts down and all you want to do is protect your eyes. So again, from here, really go at it crazy. And I'm not aiming for any particular eye. I'm just thinking about turning my hands into claws. And if you've got nails, it's even better, but it's not necessary. And I'm just scratching at them multiple times in a row. And you notice I'm not just using my hands. I'm not just going like this, which may work, but it may not. I'm putting a lot of weight into it. I'm actually acting as though I'm punching. I'm turning my hips. I'm putting a lot of power into it because I really want to dig into those eyes. If you've ever noticed in the wild, there are a lot of smaller animals who defend themselves really well against bigger animals. And one of the best examples of this is just a cat. If you've ever picked up a little cat who doesn't want to be held, it's this tiny cute little thing, but it will tear at your eyes with its claws, bite you, scream, and then run off. And there's almost nothing you can do. You want to have that same mentality. It's just going crazy at their eyes so that they react with shock and let go so you can do whatever you need to do next. And by the way, this shouldn't only be used for women. If some guy gets in your face and grabs you, you have no idea what he's gonna do to you. Scrape him once or twice in the eyes and then club him with a hammer fist. There's no shame in using whatever techniques you need to do to win the fight. The whole point in a real life situation is winning and getting away safely. So you should never feel like, oh, I can't scratch at the eyes. That's something a girl would do. No, in self-defense, you do whatever you need to do. And I've worked with a lot of self-defense instructors, really big, tough guys, former bouncers, who love this idea of reaching out first, scratching the eyes, and boom, following up with a hammer fist, or boom, following up with an elbow. It's extremely effective because while that punch may not knock them out or get their attention, scraping at their eyes definitely will. And you could do it so quickly. Even if you can't even see, even if it's dark, you know where their head is, you can scratch at them and boom, follow up with a hammer fist. So get into the habit of thinking, how can I scrape someone's eyes? It works from any angle. If they've got you in close, no matter where, just find the eyes and dig them out. The last way to attack the eyes is with an eye gouge. And this is done with your thumbs. This would be if you're in really close with your attacker, particularly if they have you pinned on the ground, but it could also be if they grab you in like a bear hug from the front. All you do here is you jam your thumbs right into their eye sockets and you grab their head and try to press. In this case, you are aiming. When you just do the rake, you're not really aiming. You're just kind of hoping that one of your fingers causes some damage. But here you actually think about grabbing the person's head and sticking your thumbs into the inside of their eye and kind of digging out their eyes. That's your mentality. You probably won't do it. I know that sounds kind of graphic and you don't have to cause any permanent damage, but that's what you want to think about doing. You want to think about driving your fingers into the inner parts of their eye and almost scooping their eyes out. I know it sounds really violent, but in a life or death situation, if you're being raped, if there's multiple people attacking you, if you're on the ground, you may be dead. Like you may not survive this attack. So if this is what it takes to get away, you need to have that in your arsenal. When you practice it, just think about being aggressive and about putting all your force into those thumbs and about really grabbing someone's head and squeezing. And you may not feel that you have that in you, and that's okay. It may take a little bit of practice, and you could practice on a pillow. Just grab a pillow or grab a stuffed animal and see what it would take to actually execute that move. While it's not pretty, it can be extremely effective in helping you get away safely. The last thing I'll say about attacking the eyes is there are people who will carry sand in their pocket. If they're in areas where they get attacked a lot or mugged a lot, someone gets in their face, they take a little handful of sand from their pocket, throw it at the person's face. Even getting one grain of sand in your eye, that's a fight ender. There's very little you want to do when you've got sand in your eyes. So well, that can be very effective. Obviously works at the beach as well. And the other thing is, you know, weapons are always better than your bare hands when it comes to self-defense. So if you can get a hold of mace or pepper spray and carry it on you and have it available to you, if someone tries to attack you, even from a distance, you know, it works. Some of them work 10 feet away. You can spray it, they get that in their eyes, and they're not gonna bother with you. So you spray it, you run away, and that's all you need to do. You don't even need to touch them. And that'll keep them busy burning for about a half an hour, 45 minutes. And by then you can be long gone. And so you don't even have to worry about tangling with them, doing any permanent damage. It's, you know, mace and pepper spray are not only extremely effective for self-defense, but they're actually very humanitarian because you don't permanently injure the other person. So if that's a concern of yours, you know, that'll work. So again, the only way that that's going to work though with mace or pepper spray, and both work by the way, they're very similar these days, is that you have to have it on you, right? A weapon will not help you if it's not on you when you're attacked. So it needs to be something that you carry with you all the time. Maybe it's on your keychain. It needs to be small enough to use. And if you're walking to your car and it's dark outside, or you're walking to a place where you don't feel safe, make sure you have it, you know, in your hand, ready to go, and don't be afraid to use it. If someone's getting in your face, you say, back off, leave me alone, spray them. And I, just as a little side note, I would never hold it up as a warning and say, don't come at me or I'll spray you. Because what they may do is just kind of cover their eyes or duck down and rush you. You kind of keep that as your little secret weapon. Stay away, leave me alone. They continue to come at you. You spray them and then you get away.